This weekend is going to be my first time competing in NPC Bikini.
Ah, so this is your very first show.
This is actually my third show.
Oh, okay.
When I lived in Texas, I competed in NPC Figure twice.
Okay. Now, have you always been athletic? Have you always had an athletic background, or?
Yes. I was homeschooled.
Awesome.
When I was younger, and so obviously you don't have a lot of classmates, so I was enrolled in multiple types of sports. Grew up swimming, playing softball, and then in college I played softball as well.
I got you. So what's the difference between normal fitness and doing like a show, preparing for a show?
Really, it's, I would say, your mentality and what your goal is. So if you just, I mean, it could in reality be the same, depending on your goals. For a show, your goal is to build muscle and then lean out. I mean, if that is your goal as just a normal like athletic person, then
right.
I mean, you could do that as well.
Right.
Towards once you get closer to the show, that kind of physique isn't always healthy because you're obviously water depleted and other things like that. But they can be the same, but ultimately, when you compete for a show, your goal towards the end is going to be slightly different.
And the diet itself is a little bit different.
Correct.
Right?
It'll change. Mm-hmm. Working with JJ, he really takes a really close look at everyone's physique and determines what's going to be best and how you and him can work.
So you've done a show
to get to that physique level.
So you've done a show with JJ and without JJ?
Negative. This is my first one with JJ.
So what was the difference in preparing for a show without JJ and then preparing for a show with
JJ? Well, I had a trainer when I was in Texas.
Okay.
Obviously, physique and bikini are two different classes, and they're looking for different things within those classes. Figure, you have a little bit more muscle. Bikini, they're looking for different things. So I can't really compare the two because the end state in those two classes is different.
Right.
But working with JJ has been energetic and he is incredibly motivating and it's been exciting. It's been a long process, but it's been exciting.
I got you. And is there any advice that you have to people who are thinking, who are wanting to compete but don't really have the nerve to do it or a little afraid?
Absolutely. So my biggest thing before I had ever competed was I don't have the like dedication, like, oh, I can't eat just fish all week long. Like, I don't have that determination. But once you get with JJ and you feel that contagious motivation that he has and that, you know, you're not going to be eating fish for 12 weeks straight, you get motivated and you set like little goals. So each week you're like, hey, this week is going to be good. And then, you know, it's a day by day process. But then once you start seeing changes, you like get even more pumped and more excited. And so I would say just do it. Do it once and see if you like it.
Awesome. And in preparation for this show, which is the
Gold Classic and the All Armed Forces.
Our Eastern Armed Forces, I think. And is there anybody that you'd like to thank? Or that's helped you with your prep?
I would like to thank JJ,
okay,
and Allie and Pops, all the coaches here at the Fit Factory. And then I have to thank my boyfriend.
Awesome.
Because he deals with my hangry episodes. And he's also a huge supporter and also been there when we ran out of chicken. And I'm like, babe, I need you to make some chicken. He's like, I'm on it. So I have to thank him as well.
They're definitely the unforgetting people in this sport.
Absolutely.
The significant others of the competitors.
Yep.
Awesome. So we'll be tracking to see how you do this weekend.
Awesome.
Good luck. You're looking excellent.
Thank you.
J'avais my late night syrup. Tu me manques vraiment. Où es-tu? Je peux venir à Chicago s'il le faut. J'ai vraiment envie de te voir.
under the red light. You mean ain't no stopping here, she told me that's right. You want all of my attention, know what it is. Told me what you want, I gave you all your needs. I got so much work overseas, they need the visa. My neck, my wrist looking flashy like the police. Pulled them titties, I swear I was in a beast. Taking shots now, so I know you aim to please. I hit the top floor in the presidential suite. Looking down on you, but all you had is. Told them no more sauce, so I'm out of favor. It ain't about the check up, then don't talk to me. Oh, yeah. Niggas claiming they got hoes, but they be pop to me. Yo, yeah. Hoe for my hoe, that's not a spot to me. According to my role, he got no time for it. Since I was young, I had a damn no dime for it. On her hands and knees is all she down for.
Shit with the shits. Backwood after backwood, greenhouse would be lit. Is it really that good? Don't make me admit. Charles made cars close, then we made a hit.
Under the red light, you mean ain't no stopping here, she told me that's right. You want all of my attention, know what it is. Told me what you want, I gave you all your needs. I got so much work overseas, they need the visa. My neck, my wrist looking flashy like the police. Pulled them titties, I swear I was in a beast. Taking shots now, so I know you aim to please. She getting checks, I keep the tally. Cancel the membership at Bally's. I work her out and give her tips. Do Pilates on the dick. I'm getting dough, I'm getting rolls now. She got some buddies, tell them roll up. Money like clothes, it's hard to fold now. Back to back, got cocoa sold out. Late nights, that's just when it goes. Under the red light, you mean ain't no stopping here. She told me that's right. You want all of my attention, know what it is. Told me what you want, I gave you all you need. I got so much work overseas, they need the visa. My neck, my wrist looking flashy like the police. Pulled them titties, I swear I was in a beast. Taking shots now, so I know you aim to please.
J'ai envie de m'allonger à côté de toi. J'ai besoin que tu me prennes dans tes bras. Appelle-moi s'il te plaît, Jay.